guys?
How are you tonight?
Great, how are you?
Yeah, I enjoyed Sundance so far.
So far, so good.
That's awesome. I'm glad to hear that for you. So, excited to go on open for Marshmallow?
Oh, super stoked. Yeah, very excited.
Excited to hear you. As I usually start with my first questions, so I like to ask all my producers that I talk to, what inspired you to start creating music and why specifically EDM?
So I was put into piano lessons in like second grade. From there, I actually hated it after a couple years, and then I quit lessons. I told my mom I have to stop, I didn't like it. And then we had a piano in our kitchen, and I figured out one day that I couldn't walk by the piano without playing it. So I was like, okay, I should probably like get back into music. So I got back into piano, and then I started listening to trance, actually. One of my friends from middle school started introducing me to people like Sasha and Digweed and a bunch of other like progressive
good
like,
artists.
Yeah, like,
take
really
good
cool
taste.
Shit. And I was like, this is tight because it's like there's so much shit going on and it's very melodic and uplifting. And so I wanted to do that and I wanted to make that. So I took piano and figured out how to make it.
Yeah, I'm glad now you use pianos like within your live performances.
Exactly, yeah.
Like, when I'm listening to music, I really like your sound. It makes you super unique.
Totally honest. It's really just like, well, yeah, I mean, if you're like being honest with yourself and making music that you really want to hear, I think it's kind of going to come out, which I think is kind of what happened. Like, I'm glad you think I have a sound because, until recently, I never really started thinking, like, okay, what is my sound? How do I make sure everything fits my sound? Like, for a while there, I was just making music that I wanted to make.
Yeah.
And then because I enjoyed it, it just kind of everything pulled from elements that I enjoy, so it kind of naturally just grew into something.
That's awesome. That's really good to hear. Going back to your piano, you said like you played piano at first.
Yeah.
And then when I see your sets, you're now incorporating like instruments in your sets besides your mixers and all that.
Yeah.
What made you decide to do that? Like, why did you think you wanted to add piano within your sets?
I like playing piano more than I like mixing. Like, I like mixing's fun and everything,
yeah.
But I'd so much rather walk up on stage like knowing I'm gonna sit down at a piano. I'm comfortable with the piano. I love the piano. And so, yeah, it's like another outlet of creativity on stage. And it kind of changes the setup a little bit every time because I might not play everything exactly the same as I played before. So it kind of like adds a little element of like freshness.
Well, that's awesome. I love how you have the tone of the sound. There's a lot of people, especially fans, like, really do that more than just like pressing play on
people,
you know? Like,
totally.
And speaking of that, do you feel that EDM shows are starting to become the next big thing when it comes to the music industry? You know, you get the live performances, like live bands, rappers, but
yeah,
EDM's a new thing. Like, what are your thoughts on it?
I don't know, I feel like EDM is pretty, it's kind of made its way into the pop scene at this point, you know what I mean? Like, EDM shows are everywhere. There's huge EDM festivals that pull so many, like, thousands of people that it's like, I mean, it is huge. And I'm also like, not lazy, but I like when I'm, like I listen to a very specific type of music and I don't generally venture out of that when I'm into one thing. So like, I'm not familiar with what kind of festivals there are out there for like rap or for rock, which is bad on my part. But I mean, the festivals that I see and that I go to, they're huge, they're massive, you know what I mean? So it's like, I don't know, I think EDM is already the big thing, you know what I mean? I already think it's like,
I mean, EDM's one of my passions. I love how the music's just grown. Like, back in the day, we had rock and roll, jazz.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, it's just technology's just taking over the music.
Well, totally. Because kids are like, how old are they when they're getting a laptop now? Like, 8 years old.
Yeah, like,
and
I see
learning
6-year-olds on iPhones
exactly.
And iPads, and it's like, what the hell?
So they're getting this technology at such a young age, and they're like, oh. And then they're seeing, like, big DJs and stuff being, like, cool and doing cool things, and they want to do that. So they have everything they need to from such a young age. So it's like, why not do that instead of learning how to play an instrument, get 500 people in a band, like, you know what I mean? It's just, like, it makes more sense.
Yeah. Well, I love your thoughts on that, guys. Like, really good.
Nice.
We at Mix love the vibe you have with Alessia. Like,
oh, it's great. Honestly, how did that even come up? We had like like, we had started that, like, about a year before we ended up releasing it, if not more than a year before that, yeah. And it went through a few versions. We had actually the very first version we ever made of that. We were listening to a lot of like M83 and Odessa, and so we wanted to make some, yeah, so good. And so the first version that we had of that was a much more like chilled back, kind of like vibey thing, and the drop was like 80 synths and like a groovy, like, it was weird, but it was still cool. But then we ended up coming back to it, making a different version. Now the Where'd You Go track, you know what I mean? It's a little bigger, and, you know, and yeah, it was just kind of a shit show process of us being like, this sounds cool, this is fun, this fucking is, and then eventually we're like, wait, this is kind of tight, we should finish this and put it out, and so we did that.
Yeah, and that's like one artist I talked to said that, like, at first when he played the small song, he didn't like it at first, yeah. But then once I was like, no, I dig it, yeah, yeah, yeah. He's like, well, yeah, I guess this sounds pretty cool. So it's really interesting to hear that, like, some producers actually don't like the song, so I think it's weird at first.
Totally.
So it's actually interesting to hear that.
Definitely. Yeah, it's weird. Every track is different. Exactly. Sometimes it can be flipped. You can start off, like, make a song one night, you're like, I love this, and then wake up the next day, and this is the garbage. This is the worst song I've ever made. So it's weird. You get both, you know?
Yeah, it's all about perspective.
Yeah.
So I just recently, I've been reading about the different summer festival lines that have been going up. And they're truly amazing. And I heard that you just got announced that you're going to be performing at Monterey.
Yeah.
How's it feel though? What's your thoughts on, like, well, how does it feel being doing at maybe not so EDM festival like the other artists?
Totally, I'm very excited.
That's awesome.
Just cause I like, I don't know, like EDM, I love EDM, I love dance music, but I also love going to a show and not being expected to like rage the whole time, you know what I mean? So like, something like Bonnaroo, you have so many vibes, you can go check out kind of whatever you want and like chill over at the set if you want, like just hang out, listen to some like pretty shit, and then if you want to turn up, you can go over here and watch like some dubstep, like,
yeah,
I love that idea.
Yeah, you get like different vibes.
Exactly.
You know,
yeah, so I don't know.